Welcome to Worship with Peace and Lord of Life Lutheran Churches. Today, we are so glad that you are here, whether you are joining us online or by phone. We're glad we can connect this way, and we give thanks for one another's presence, even as we are apart. If you need a bulletin for today's service and you have internet access, you can go to peaceaustin.org and download a PDF or print it, pull it up on another device. If you do not have access to that and you do have an Evangelical Lutheran worship hymnal, you'll be able to use that for portions of our worship today. We're singing from setting 8 in the front of the book, which I meant to double check what page it started on before I began these announcements, and then I forgot, so I will look now. That service music begins on page 184, the small numbers in the bottom corner. Some of the service music you'll find there. And then the hymns that we'll be singing today are number 479, We Come to the Hungry Feast, and number 535, Hallelujah, We Sing Your Praises. Thanks to everyone who sent in a short Peace Be With You greeting, a photo or a video. Those will end our liturgy today as greetings of peace to share with each other. You are welcome to continue sending in video messages or photos. With a Peace Be With You message somewhere, like maybe holding it up written on paper or printed out. We'll use those to end our liturgy, and thank you for sending them. And you can send them to office@peaceaustin.org. You can also tag us on any of our social media pages and send them that way. Speaking of social media, the Peace Lutheran Austin Facebook page has a new group affiliated with it called Friends of Peace Lutheran Austin, so that there's a more casual space for sharing conversation, prayer requests, ideas, questions, photos, just anything that you'd like to share, but that isn't really part of the Peace public organizational page. So anyone connected to Peace who wants to join there can find some sharing and space to connect. Special welcome today to Vicar Jason Mills, starting his time with Lord of Life Lutheran Church. We'll welcome him officially into his role in worship today, but we are so excited for him and for Lord of Life and for their journey and this chapter of it beginning today. As you probably know, but maybe you don't, today is a new day for our worshiping communities in that beginning this week, we are sharing communion together through online worship after much reflection and preparation. So if you are here on Sunday morning at 10 a.m. or close to that, then immediately following the video that you're watching now, this service, there will be a second part of worship that you can join if you choose, and that will be via Zoom. You can connect either by phone or by computer. There was a link sent out in the Peace email. It will also be copied in the Facebook comments right as worship. This portion of worship is ending. We have separated these two pieces of our service so that the service that we're sharing now can be available online on an ongoing way and by phone. So if you're connecting now after Sunday morning, we still want you to be able to worship with us. But because we know that communion comes to us in the gathered assembly, that Christ comes to us not only individually but in community, and that's such an important part of our sacramental theology, we want to be able to share that all in the same moment, which is why we are sharing it live over Zoom. It will also be on our Facebook live stream if you can't connect to Zoom, but only on Sunday morning. And so if you've missed August 2nd's communion liturgy and you really would like to commune with us, you can look forward to, again, we'll have communion on August 16th. The same way. So if you have any questions about how to participate in that, please don't hesitate to reach out. Or if this is a way you simply cannot participate, as we are able safely to do it, we will share the sacrament in the ways that are available to us so that our sacramental practice can hopefully be always striving to be as wide as the welcome that God offers in inviting all of us to God's table. If you are on the Zoom call, either by phone or computer, for communion following the end of the liturgy itself, anyone who wishes is welcome to stay and have some time for fellowship. So you're also welcome to stay and do that. And so if you don't have communion elements ready right now and you're here on Sunday morning, invite you to let part of your preparation maybe be gathering things for communion if you want to do that. If you received a care package from Peace, you might have already baked bread. If you didn't get one of those care packages or didn't have a chance to bake, then you can gather bread that you have at home, any kind. Even a simple cracker will do. We know that God makes very much out of very little. We'll hear more about that today. And so we know that whatever we have, God will make it enough. So I invite you to prepare whatever things in your ordinary space help remind you of God's sacred presence, whether that is lighting a candle, or having a bowl of water, or gathering your elements for communion so that you are ready if you will be participating in that part of worship today. As we prepare to hear the prelude, I would like to invite you to use this time as a time of reflection in preparation for confession and forgiveness. So hear these words of call to confession. The sun of righteousness shall rise with shining beams of healing. Let us gather under the wings of God's mercy. As we hear the music of the prelude, we reflect inwardly on what we need to confess and how we might repent before God to turn our hearts towards God's grace and purpose. Gracious God, we acknowledge that we are sinners, and we confess our sins, those known to us that burden our hearts, and those unknown to us but seen by you. We know that before you nothing remains hidden, and in you everything is revealed. Free us from being trapped in sin. Liberate us from the bondage of guilt. Work in us that which is pleasing in your sight, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. From the house of David, God raised up a mighty Savior. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who comes to set us free. Remembering the covenant, God delivered us from our enemies. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who comes to set us free. Before God, we are holy and righteous, free to worship without fear. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who comes to set us free. With a heart full of mercy and compassion, God saves us and forgives us all our sins. Christ, the dawn from on high, shines upon us, and by the light of the Holy Spirit, guides our feet in the way of peace. Amen. Today, we give thanks for new beginnings, for our continued journeys of growth, and for the calling of the various seasons of life. Today, Lord of Life Lutheran Church, with Peace Lutheran Church in witness and support, welcome Vicar Jason Mills into service among them.
Let us pray. O God, through the Holy Spirit, you prepare and guide those who are called to be pastors and teachers. We pray for your continual presence in the seminaries of the ELCA and upon all seminaries as they seek to instruct those preparing to serve in the ministry of your church. Bless your people in this congregation, who by word and example aid your servant Jason in learning to do the ministry for which he is being prepared. As we diligently work together, grant that our lives may be enriched and our ministries filled with joy, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
From 1 Corinthians, the Apostle Paul writes, "Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are varieties of service, but the same Lord, and there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone." In the coming year, the intern will work with the supervising pastor in this congregation to be formed as a pastor and to develop skills for pastoral ministry. Vicar Jay, are you willing to assume your partnership in ministry here, and will you seek to engage in that ministry to God's glory? If so, answer, "I am, and I ask God to help and guide me."
"I am, and I ask God to help and guide me."
In the coming months, the members of this congregation and the supervising pastor are asked to accept this intern as a partner in ministry, welcoming him into their home when it is safe, sharing in his learning and growth, and encouraging, supporting, and praying for him. Now I ask you, will you receive Jason as a partner in ministry and uphold and support him in every way? If so, answer yes by God's help.
Yes by God's help.
Almighty God, by whose call we are at work, bless us in our labors together. God, we ask you to bless this congregation and to sustain all who labor in it. Make us faithful to your word. Empower us to show one another and all creation your justice and love, and bring all at last to your heavenly home through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may God go before you to show you the way, be behind you to encourage and inspire you, be beside you as your faithful friend, be above you to watch over you, be within you to give you peace. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Vicar Jason, welcome to your time among the people of Lord of Life Lutheran Church, people of Lord of Life. Welcome your new leader. May you all be blessed and be a blessing in this time.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray together the prayer of the day. Glorious God, your generosity waters the world with goodness, and you cover creation with abundance. Awaken in us a hunger for the food that satisfies both body and spirit, and with this food, fill all the starving world. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The first reading is from Isaiah. Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you that have no money, come, buy, and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you. Because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The psalm today is number 145, verses 8 through 9 and 14 through 21. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. The Lord is good to all, and his compassion is over all that he has made. The Lord upholds all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look to you, and you give them the food in due season. You open your hand, satisfying the desire of every living thing. The Lord is just in all his ways, and kind in all his doings. The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth. He fulfills the desire of all who fear him. He also hears their cry and saves them. The Lord watches over all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth will speak the praise of the Lord, and all flesh will bless his holy name forever and ever.
The second reading is from Romans. I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart, for I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred, according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Good morning. Our children's sermon this morning is going to be a small video that my daughter and I put together regarding both the celebration of communion that we're going to have today and tying in our gospel lesson. So without further ado...
Good morning, and welcome to Cooking with the Vicar.
And Ava.
This is my daughter, Ava. She's going to be assisting me today. What we're going to do is we're going to make the gluten-free communion bread recipe. We've pre-measured all of these ingredients, which we did get on Amazon Fresh. We only had to substitute one ingredient. I couldn't find teff flour, so we're using almond flour instead. And this is now the second time that we've baked this. We did do a test run, which we'll show you a little bit later. Almond flour. Yeah. Just this one.
1 teaspoon of teff flour or the almond flour. And then 3/4 a tablespoon of the brown rice flour.
Teaspoon. You do. It's cool. This is Ava's favorite.
God. 3/4 a teaspoon of tapioca flour.
Very good.
Okay. And then 1/8 a teaspoon of whole
psyllium.
Psyllium husk. And then a pinch of baking soda.
If all you have in your kitchen is baking soda and not baking powder, the differences are not going to be that great. Powder will just make it a little bit more cakey. And we can get into the science of baking in another video.
And then a pinch of salt.
And then you just want to whisk all the dry ingredients together. And then I preheated this hot water here, and we're just going to add 1.5 teaspoons to the honey, which is 1/4 teaspoon. Then you just want to mix your wet ingredients together, and because we use such hot water, it'll actually mix pretty easily. Some of the things that we find to be very calming in this time of pandemic, we certainly wanted to have the discussion about how school or the lack of school or the way that things change in a very drastic fashion sometimes affects us, specifically our kids and teenagers. Ava's going to be a freshman this year, but one of the things that we kind of looked at, specifically as we're looking at the story of Jesus feeding the 5,000 people, this story begins with Jesus being saddened and frustrated at hearing about the death of his cousin, John the Baptist. And then he goes off alone. And we assume that he does this because this is the human side of Jesus, who can be sad, who can be angry, and who needs those moments of just aloneness. And so, one of the things that Ava and I had talked about was what are some of the things that she does when she feels sad and frustrated. And one of those was to just kind of be alone in an effort to really think about and kind of process those feelings. And then of course we talked about how that sense of community has changed, the things that we find to be life-giving and important for us now. And so kind of like, this little baking demonstration, the opportunity that we have for community as, small microcosms, small groups, our families getting together and things of that nature, those have become even more important now than they were before. And so, Ava, what are some of the ways that you've been able to spend time with your friends this summer without actually getting together?
We Zoom a lot. We basically go and talk to each other on Zoom or FaceTime or whatever. Or text. It's not exactly the same, but we're still together. We're still talking and in together-ish, but not real, not
together, but separate.
Yeah.
So you're experiencing that same community in a different way, but you're still feeling connected to that group of friends. So we're going to go ahead and pop this in the oven for 6 minutes, and then you'll make a sign of the cross, and then we'll show you another design option. For the top of the bread, we'll brush it with some grapeseed oil, and then we'll throw it back in the oven for another 6 minutes, and then we'll see you in 12 minutes and show you our final product. Thanks. And so, like I said, we took these out halfway through. And we brush them with grapeseed oil, and we cut these little designs. So here's the just traditional plain old props. Ava got a little creative, and she went and did the chi ro, is how it's spelled. Chi ro is how it's pronounced. The two first letters in Greek for the word Christ. And so it's basically as Ava would tell you, it's P over top of an X, and in fact it's a it's two Greek letters, chi and ro. So these are our communion wafers, and later today we'll have an opportunity to celebrate the Eucharist with this opportunity to bake together. And so I hope this was helpful. I hope you guys have an opportunity to bake as a family or as a couple. and you know, just enjoy the time that we have, without a doubt. Should we say a little prayer? Dear God, we thank you for the opportunities we have to look at this life with the abundance that you have granted us. And we hope that we can continue to take that abundance in all ways and in all places out to the people that you call us to serve. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 14th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now, when Jesus heard about the beheading of John the Baptist, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish." And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds, and all ate and were filled, and they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace and peace I bring to you from God, our Creator, and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Hunger. We talk about it often. It is all too easy to view these passages in their simplest form, the lack of food and the scarcity we encounter through these without means. In this time of our lives during the coronavirus pandemic, it is perhaps easier to engage the lack of physical nourishment as our nation faces an unemployment pandemic amidst the threat of severe illness. Nearly 33 million of our siblings are without work in order to put food where it matters most, into the bellies of the bodies that they care for most. It would be simple to end the sermon here with a call to expand our food ministries, to reach to those without, to bless our loaves and fishes that God may see our gifts and grant that they grow and reach those who are in need and for whom the threat of physical hunger is a real and ever-present danger both today and tomorrow. I won't not say that. And also, we are hungry for peace. The Bible often uses food and drink to bring our attention to non-physical nourishment. While it is important to fill the belly, it is also important to engage the mind and the soul. It is important to engage these latter two aspects of our being together. The mind and the soul are linked, as one does not act without the other. Have you ever been accused of being hangry? My family often uses this term to denote that time when the stomach begins to rob civility from the mind, creating some discord in the souls of those gathered. And many of us are feeling scarcity in our souls too, I surmise. We experience the hunger of a great many things during these days of pandemic, and we, the church, hunger for assembly and fellowship, a return to normalcy, wherein worship and fellowship happen on Sundays, and the work of the church can continue in more tangible and present ways for both us and for whom we are called to labor. We hear that the church is deployed, and while that fact remains true, what does that actually mean? And as the days of the pandemic seem to extend beyond measure and count, what does that mean for the tomorrow that isn't yet here? We are so hungry for community. Deployment, a noun. The movement of troops or equipment to a place or a position for military action, or the action of bringing resources into effective action. And while I can attest to the validity of both aspects of this definition, I think the latter applies to the church more than the former. Truly, it is a matter of perspective. As we have learned, the fracturing of community in recent months in this country, hopefully we have learned that perspectives are valuable tools to use when engaging one another and looking for ways to identify our implicit and explicit needs. We are so hungry for answers. I was in the Navy for 21 years, just retiring this last summer. And of those 21 years, I spent a little over 500 days at sea, deployed, and deployed for just under a year to Iraq. In the grand scheme of things, an aggregate time of being away from home equaling about 2 years doesn't seem like much. Even when you add the details of isolation on a submarine, where anywhere from 115 to 180 of your future best friends isolated with you on this steel tube modern marvel, or in the war zone where the number of future best friends decreases, but there is sunshine, so much sunshine, and also mortars being lobbed over the walls that are meant to provide the slightest deterrent to such action. There are obvious positives and negatives to each of these scenarios, but there is a common positive aspect to these experiences, and it is the lengths to which people will go to engage community. Ways that feed body, mind, and soul, ways that support and uplift, ways that seek to give life rather than take it away. The use of these resources during a deployment is often new and dynamic, where people and tools are used in ways not necessarily as they were designed. The Navy has a habit of teaching its sailors to do more with less, and we routinely accomplish that, even when it comes to supporting one another while completing the mission for which we are deployed. So my longest single deployment was 96 days, wherein we spent most of those 96 days under seas and oceans, conducting our mission and supporting national security. This was also my second at sea deployment. And as the mission went, there were not many surprises. And of course, any military leader can tell you that the last thing that they want on a deployment is a surprise. And for all intents and purposes, the mission completely met my expectations. Lots of work, a couple of fires, totally normal and not at all life-threatening, a few personnel issues. What I did not expect was the malaise and depression amongst my sailors, some of whom have deployed many times before. There were many factors that played into this. The long hours, we worked 12-hour shifts, 7 days a week for the whole trip. The extreme isolation, you know, no word from any loved ones back home. And only having had 3 weeks of reprieve between the first and the second parts of this deployment. One thing that I started doing and counseling my sailors to do was to keep a food journal. Now that seems superbly counterintuitive, I know, but just hear me out. I love food a lot. And while food on submarines is better than that on surface ships, the bar is sometimes set pretty low, especially when you have depleted your stores of food and suddenly everything is being rationed and paired with noodles and rice. And I mean everything. My stomach was not being sated. It was being filled, but it wasn't feeding my sense of normalcy. My need for food that felt good was increasing beyond the food's ability to supply the full measure of nourishment needed to give everything I could to my team, the crew, and the mission. And while my food journal started out as nothing more than a personal exercise in remembering the life-giving nature of food in general, it also supplied an opportunity to engage the community around me in a conversation about food. We were able to gather around a future table and discuss cooking, the gathering of friends and family, and eating, and the quintessential human needs for nourishing the mind, body, and soul. And the sharing of these meals created new relationships for many and provided a sense of community renewed to see us through to the end of this deployment. We are hungry for renewal. Today, we have the opportunity to express an increased level of faith community through an online communion service. Holy Communion has always been a symbol of the forgiveness of sin for us, but this one is ending a long-standing fast brought about by a horrific global pandemic affecting the body of Christ the world over. In this moment, I understand that my own food journal experience much differently. It wasn't what happened that made the experience and that period of isolation better, but the collective sense of giving that changed the tide of malaise. The bringing together of people from various personal histories is one thing, but for each person to give of themselves in order to feed the mind and souls of others is akin to living out our faith in exigent circumstances, not unlike what we are going through in this pandemic together, but separately. Today, we join in gathering with other faithful who have made the decision to celebrate the Eucharist while isolated, not unlike the groups that were gathered in the wilderness of Bethsaida with Christ more than 2,000 years ago, where God, through Christ, gave another reminder of abundance in faith. Many of us have unknowingly quoted the disciples this morning, saying that it was past time for normal refreshment. We all understand hunger, and that no need is so keen, nothing else so imperiously demands supply as those needs of hunger and thirst. Because of our understanding and ability to decry the forces of hunger, we can easily transition the analogous meaning of hunger and thirst to receiving of salvation in this meal through the nourishment of our souls. As Isaiah says, all who hunger, all who thirst are welcome. We are called to share these gifts through thought, word, and deed as we move forward from this place and space into the world, whether it be with those who we encounter socially distancing, a phone call, or an email, an online meeting, or a shared meal experience over video conferencing, as some of my fellow seminarians and I do from time to time, all while recognizing that people can experience that salvation, the satisfaction of hunger and thirst through us and encountering Christ in us. Christ alone fed as many as 10,000 women, children, and men so many years ago with just a small amount of actual food, wherein the scarcity that would normally feel like failure was, in fact, abundance. And with Christ, we always have the opportunity together to reach out and be the face of Christ to just as many, if not more. So whether you experience communion this morning or you end your worship experience with this spirit-stirred message of hope and renewal, my hunger is that we all end this day in renewal together, reminded that the word of God, wine and bread, is a symbol of God's everlasting grace, a free gift of life, always offering us consolation and magnifying Christ with and within us. We are given these gifts freely, freeing us to move forward in God's call for us to stand for the outcast, speak for the silenced, heal the sick, comfort those in need of nourishment. And as we share this word, this bread of life, we are sent forth to give ourselves away as bread for all. Amen. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we die and rise with Christ. We are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. We are called to be co-workers in the life-giving reign of God. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. Throughout the prayer, as you hear the words, "We give thanks for this gift and this calling," you are invited to respond, "We give thanks for the water of life." Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. We give thanks for this gift and this calling. We give thanks for the water of life, the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. We give thanks for this gift and this calling. We give thanks for the water of life. At the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By water and your word, you claim us as sons and daughters, making us heirs of your promise and servants of all. We give thanks for this gift and this calling. We give thanks for the water of life. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life, and above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. We give thanks for this gift and this calling. We give thanks for the water of life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. I ask you to join me in professing your faith in Christ Jesus and confess the faith of the Church, the faith in which we baptize with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You take resources that appear to be meager, bless them, and there is enough. May your church trust what you bless and ask us to share with the world is abundantly sufficient. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your bountiful creation offers sustenance and life for all creatures. Protect this abundance for the well-being of all. Preserve the damage we have caused your creation. Replenish groundwater supplies, provide needed rains in places of drought, and protect forests from the wildfires. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You offer yourself to all the nations and peoples of the earth, inviting everyone to abundant life. Bring the prophetic vision to fullness that all nations will run to you and that nations who do not know you will find their joy in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. Hear the anguish of tender hearts who cry to you in suffering and satisfy their deepest needs. Bring wholeness and healing to those who suffer in body, heart, soul, and mind, especially those on our congregation prayer list and those we name before you now, silently or aloud. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You offer freely the fullness of salvation. Grant peace and, Lord of life, such a welcoming heart that our words and actions may extend your free and abundant hospitality to all whom we encounter. May Vicar Jay feel this welcome and be part of extending it to others. Lord, in our mercy, hear our prayer. You gather your saints as one, united in the body of Jesus. Bring us with all your saints to the heavenly banquet. We remember with love and thanksgiving the saints we have known. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
In the certain hope that nothing can separate us from your love, we offer these prayers to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As we prepare to hear the offering music, we take this moment to reflect on how we steward all those things with which God has provided us, which may seem meager, but out of which we trust God will make an abundance. May you have joy and gratitude in your heart today as you think of what God has given you, because when we bring it to God's feast, it is made enough and more than enough for all. We reflect on this promise and how we steward our gifts in these days as we listen to the music of the offering.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of goodness and growth, all creation is yours, and your faithfulness is as firm as the heavens. Nourish us through your abundant grace, that we might proclaim your steadfast love in our communities and in the world, through Jesus Christ, our strength and our song. Amen. Lord, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Now receive this blessing. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God, the Creator, Jesus, the Christ, and the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, bless you and keep you in eternal love. Amen. For those who are with us for worship on Sunday morning, our service will continue after the peace with Holy Communion. You will have to follow the Zoom link that is in the comments on Facebook or that you received by email, or call in the number for the Zoom call to join us there. There will also be a new Facebook Live video that will begin momentarily with that part of the liturgy. If you're here live on Facebook, and if you're coming to us later, we look forward to hopefully having you as part of communion on August 16th if you feel called to that, and we look forward to any questions that can help you join us at that table if that is somewhere that you would like to be. But for now, the peace of the Lord be with you always. Receive now some greetings of peace from our community. If you wish to send your own photo or video offering greetings of peace, we'll continue to share these in worship as time goes on.
Hi all, wishing y'all peace and comfort in these troubling times. Thinking of you and hoping to see you soon.
Peace of the Lord be with you.